Hey guys, in this video I will show you how to use Editorial Mixed Media Effects, which is Adobe Photoshop ActionScript. It's an extension that will allow you to create this effect on any photo, any image, and it's very easy to use. Let's watch some previews. Okay, those were some of the examples. Now let's see how to install and use the extension in your Adobe Photoshop, and you will be able to transform a photo from this into this. When we download the Editorial Mixed Media Effects, we get a series of files and folders, and one of them is the Effects tool. So we can use the Effects tool with another plugin, which is called the Effects Box. You can get it for free here at theorangebox.com. You download the plugin and install it, it's very simple, and you get access to a series of effects and other plugins, which is really, really awesome because it will speed up and change your workflow completely. So once you have installed this tool, you go in your Adobe Photoshop and you will find it in Window, Extensions, Effects Box. Once you have opened the Effects Box, you just click on the plus icon, and you have to navigate in the folder of the Editorial Mixed Media Effects, where there is a folder called Effects Tool and then a file called installer.jsx. You just double click on the installer.jsx and the effect will be in your library. So how to apply this effect on our photo? First of all, let me delete everything and start over. This was the starting image. We have to apply the selection, so decide the area where we want effect. First of all, I'm going to use a magnetic lasso tool, which is really useful in this case because it makes a really rough selection, which is appropriate in this case. But you can use any tool you want, the brush tool, the normal lasso tool, the pen tool, and create a selection around your subject. Keep in mind that every time you make a new selection or a different selection, you will come up with a different result. So experiment and try different times and you will get a different result. Now I'm removing some areas, for example, and once I made my selection, I create a new layer and fill it with any color. Then I go in the panel, the effects box, and select mixed media, and then apply this effect. You have to be sure that this layer is selected and the background photo is also visible. So once you have this condition, click on your mask and apply this effect. So this is the final result, and we can modify everything in the composition and make it unique, adding our own colors. For example, we have paint drops, white strokes, which is a very important layer that I indicate in red because it will change the brightness of the composition by a lot. So keep in mind that you might want to change this most of the times. And then we have the watercolor base, which is the main part of the subject, painted in watercolor, black pencil, which contains some strokes and lines around the subject, and then in the extra elements group you have all the extra elements, so like the dots, the pattern, and all these funky lines that you can mitigate or even remove. We're going to apply the effect on this photo now because I want to show you how you can modify the layers and create something really cool. Some of the layers will need adjustments, as I told you before, so I want to show you. Make a new selection, create a new layer, fill it with any color, and start the effect from the effects box. Keep in mind, guys, that you can always install the script traditionally, placing it in your Adobe Photoshop script folder, and you will have it here, but I suggest you to get it with the effects box because you can control it very easily and apply the effect a lot more quickly. Once you made the area selected, click apply. is the final result in black and white, so we can give a color to the elements and adjust some of the layers. For example, in this case, white strokes will create always a prominent brightness to the image, and we may want to reduce the effect of this layer. So to do that, we selected, for example, we have accented edges and white lines. These two layers, we select them and we reduce the fill. Reducing the fill is different than reducing the opacity, because it will actually reduce the effect and not the opacity itself. So what else we can do? We can give color to the background image. For example, we can double click and add a simple color overlay. And this will affect a lot the overall image, as you can see. Let's choose, for example, this color, a reddish one. And then we can change the colors of the extra elements. For example, we can change the newspaper text, we can remove the layer mask, we can do everything we want at this point. The dots pattern, for example, we can add some colors. If you want to take it to the next step, in the folder, the Editorial Media Effects, you have the brushes as well. So if you double click or open in Photoshop, you will have the brushes, which are the assets like the newspaper or the pattern here, or the watercolor brushes. So you click B on your keyboard, you create a new layer, for example, on top of everything, and you can you will have the brushes here. So you have all the assets to work and adjust the details of the image. For example, let me show you, we can add some more splatter colors to the image. We use the Alt key to campionate the color, and we add some more splatter brushes. Yeah, that's it. We can do a lot of more things, like color the other elements or remove them. Depending on what you remove or show, the result will be different. For example, in this case, it's just a watercolor sketch. You can remove the black pencil. You can also do this. Select them, invert with Ctrl or Command I, and change the blending options instead of multiply into screen, so they will look white. Also, creating a gradient map will change drastically the look of the image. So for example, if I choose some color and then I go into hue mode, I can have a totally new look. That's how I made the preview images, and I hope you like this effect.